Welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm going to do a preview today on the match, the first match, the 2020 match of Indian Premier League. And I've got Mithil from India, and we're going to discuss the playing 11. And we're also going to discuss the reasons why RCB, they just couldn't make it in the end. They have always the best team, and they have also got the fan following in India, especially if we say after Mumbai Indians, RCB is the second team. They have got the most fan following in India, all over the world, even in Pakistan. The fans, the only reason they support RCB is just because of Virat Kohli and AB de Villiers, and now they have got Maxwell also in their team. So the fan following and the team they have got, he was initially the most expensive player in IPL, Maxwell, and then someone else ended up as a most expensive player. So Mithil, what do you think, who should be the playing for RCB today, the playing 11? And then Mumbai Indians, they have always got the best team, especially with Jasprit Bumrah or Trent Bolt. So who you think they're going to do something different? I think so. In the initial phases of the Indian Premier League, RCB, they always end up winning matches. But when it's coming to the crunch moments, especially later on in the tournament, especially after 20 matches or 15 matches, they end up losing match against any weaker team, especially it could be any Kings 11, Punjab, Rajasthan Royal. So what do you think, RCB, they're going to do this time something different as compared to Mumbai, or they can upset any other teams, or who you think will be the strongest team in this tournament this time?
Before going ahead, I want to say that there is one stat about both the teams, that Mumbai Indians have never won an opening match since 2013. And while Royal Challengers Bangalore have never won a match at Chepauk since 2014. All right, so these are the stats for both the teams. And the RCB always RCB has been known for the batting department. They had Chris Gayle. They had many good batters, but they have always lacked a good death bowlers. Who would give a performance at a crunch situation like Mumbai Indians have, like Jasprit Bumrah. Then sometimes Hardik Pandya comes, turns up and takes a one off two wickets. Then Rahul Chahar they have. So, this time they have gone towards the all-rounders like Kylie Jamieson. He's the most expensive player in this auction, like around 15.6 crores. So I am hoping that he will play today. So this will be there are four foreign players who will be playing for RCB. I guess will be the AB de Villiers, then Glenn Maxwell he will play, then I think they will go with Kylie Jamieson. So there are three, and then I guess they will go with Kane Richardson, because they have actually bought a good domestic players. Now, RCB comes from the state of Karnataka, right? So Karnataka always have a very good domestic players. Karnataka, if you see the performance of a domestic team of a Karnataka in the domestic tournaments, they have always performed really well. So before that, they were not much investing in the Karnataka players, but now there's a purchase Devdutt Padikkal, then Azharuddin. So I'm hoping that they would play today. My lineup for RCB will be Virat Kohli and Padikkal opening. Then third, I guess they will send AB de Villiers. Fourth will be Azharuddin. Fifth maybe Glenn Maxwell. Then they have Kylie Jamieson. Then maybe six and seventh will be, I guess, Ken Richardson. I would say that he will play. Then they have a Yuzvendra Chahal as well. Then they have domestic bowlers like Siraj and Navdeep Saini. So these are the players I'm hoping to see from RCB.
Okay, and what do you think about Mumbai Indians? They always have a best team, and they hardly lose any match since the start of the tournament, and then later on also.
Well, I guess we would be seeing another new opening batsman to, I guess Rohit Sharma, as Quinton de Kock just landed in India and he's in right now he's in quarantine. He hasn't joined Mumbai Indians team yet. All right, so I guess we'll be seeing Rohit Sharma and Ishan Kishan as opening. Then Surya Kumar Yadav is number three. Then I guess they will go with Saurabh Tiwari or Pollard Hardik. So I guess this will be the batting lineup.
So what do you think that RCB, they're going to, at least they will be going for playoffs, or what do you think? Because there is always, you know, we see quite a lot memes on social media about Virat Kohli that, you know, they started making fun. Soon fan realized that RCB, they are heading towards like a clumsy. You know, they might be eliminated. You know, the criticism starts from all over the world. Like, and so you think RCB or Virat Kohli, there is a myth which they can break in this IPL, because you know there is still a tag. Virat Kohli is the best captain for so far for the Indian cricket team, but especially for RCB, he couldn't win a tournament so far. So what do you think?
If you look at the last decade from 2010 to 2016, they have performed on a consistent basis. Yes, they didn't win a single IPL, but there were hardly one or two seasons that they in which they couldn't reach to the playoffs. But after 2016, like from 2017 to 2020, they have reached playoffs only for one time. 2017, I guess they were in 5th, 6th or 7th position. Same thing was in 2018 season. 2019, they were below par. And 2020, they reached playoffs. But, you know, even at for the first 10 matches, they were performing well. And they couldn't win a single match in the last four league matches. But as they performed, because of their good performance, the first 10 matches, they could reach the in the playoffs. So this time also, they should target first the playoff position, and then they should go for the final.
Okay, and who you think will be the second or the third most tough team in this tournament to be beaten? What do you think about Chennai Super Kings? They have got now Moeen Ali, and there was a lot of debate and chat about Mahinder Singh Dhoni that he might come up. It could be his last tournament, but I think so. He might play another one or two seasons. But what you think, Chennai Super Kings, have they got a better team as compared to the last year? Because the last year team, there was a team combination problems and they had a weaker team, especially Watson. He has just gone past his peak. So he has announced retirement also now. So what do you think? Yeah.
Actually, CSK. Actually, before CSK, we need to talk about Mahendra Singh Dhoni as a captain. You know, Mahendra Singh Dhoni relies on spinners rather than pace unit. And this time this season for the first time, not a single team will be playing at their home ground. You know, so CSK will be playing mostly in Wankhede or another pitches where spinners might not come into play. So, and CSK always has been spinning unit, so that could be the reason that might not reach in the playoffs. But today we got a news that Jason Barrandov from Australia has replaced Josh Hazlewood. So it would be dependent on Dhoni how he chooses his four core players from foreign department. So it would be it will be tricky thing for tricky thing for Dhoni, but let's see how they do well. As I'm a CSK supporter, I would see CSK going into the playoffs, if not winning the cup.
Before you go, the last what's your prediction for today, RCB or MI?
IPL toss thing is really matters, and Virat Kohli has a history of losing the toss. So there are odds that Mumbai Indians do not win in the first match, so I would be going with RCB this time.
RCB. And but what about the four finalists? What you think, like four semi-finalists, four teams?
I would go with first team. I would go with the Sunrisers Hyderabad. Second team will be Mumbai Indians. Third team will be Punjab Kings because they have a very good the whole unit is amazingly. So, and the fourth will be between, I guess, KKR or Delhi.
Delhi. So Rishabh Pant is
Or maybe
captain.
Bangalore.
Bangalore. Okay. Thanks for your time today, Mittal. And hope in the later part of this tournament, I will call you again and I'll give you a shout, especially over the weekend. So special thanks. And don't for the viewers, please don't forget to follow Mittal on Twitter. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. Thanks for your time. Cheers. Bye.